So here's my latest and greatest pattern knot board here. I hope you all enjoy. I did do it with a candy brown, which I wasn't real excited at first to go do another candy brown one, since that's the last three boards that I did. But my friend who wanted one said he wanted the candy brown because he loved it. And here it is. On the center, I like to do my paint effects in the center of the board because that's where your eyes are going to be drawn when you first look at it. So I went with the water drops, of course. They're one of my favorites. And there they are after they dry. After they dry, I put three coats of inner coat clear over it to hold them down. Really light first one, and then two decent coats over that after that dries. I went around along the outside with some tape to put some lines there before I shade. I'd like to put the shading around the lines, and then you pull that tape up and it looks real good. You can still see more of the outer water drops, which are usually the smaller ones. And it leaves you plenty of room in the center. There's the shading. Plenty of room in the center for what I like to do is my flake fade out, which you'll see here in just a moment. There it is. I put more inner coat clear to hold the shading down before I do the flake fade out. There's the tape for the flake fade I decided to go with. And there's the flake. I went with the gold flake because that's what color the board is. Usually I'd do silver if it was a silver board, but I love the gold on gold. I think it turned out really nice. Then on the out, then I mask out each section of the board separately. That way I can pull it off as I'm painting it. Right here, I did not mask out the outside or the center lines because that's going to be the base of the board, the base color, which I put white. That way it will get rid of the flake. As far as the base color, I didn't want it to be all flaky and blingy because it takes away from the center patterns. And I went with the candy root beer brown along the white, which you can see here. It looks like an oak desk or something. Maybe not an oak desk, maybe maple or something like that. But it looks really smooth. It looks really good, and it's a good outer base. And I just like the way it looks. Kind of like on a car, you would have your base color of the car, and then the patterns would be full of flake and catch your eye in the sun. Right here, I went around the other line. I had that line taped off there, and I went along with it with like a really light brown, brownish white, and then I sprayed like some speckles of brown on top of that just to try something different, see how it looked. Here in the middle, I went with the candy streaking. So I just took a microfiber towel, put a little bit of a reducer on it and streaked out the paint, and then went along the outside of it with some shading. I think it turned out really cool. It looks really good around in the water drops, which you'll see here. I went around the outside of it with kind of a fade on the inside where I just painted the lines, the tape lines on the outside, and then let the overspray kind of work its way in so that it gets light. And then I pulled the tape and put a light dusting of candy over that, just so that it's not gold, but it's more of the brown. Right there is my upper and lower paint fades with the tape. As you can see there, you just pull the tape after it's all dark, and then you put a little bit in the middle and kind of shade it. Right here is my, I guess you'll call them skid marks. I should have put some tape on the outside of them to keep that overspray, which ends up not being a big deal because I go around it with shading, which I did not do here, but I changed my mind after looking at it and went around the whole thing with the shading, which turned out really cool. You can see where I turned out some of the shading on part of this, which looks really good. And then right here, everything's shaded, everything's done except for right there around the skid marks. If you look closely, you can see where the overspray kind of went over, which after I shade it, you can't even tell, which you'll be able to tell once you see it with the clear coat on here. If you're liking this content, give me a like, share, subscribe. If you want me to do something else, if you want to see the process a little bit more detail, closer, and me explaining it with each step, which turns out to be longer videos, Let me know what you guys think. If you would rather see that, I don't mind doing that. It's just a longer video, and then some people don't really want, they're not that far in depth with wanting to know exactly every little detail of it, but I don't mind doing it. Here's the end process, just about. As you can see, you can kind of see where the tape lines and the first 3-4 coats of clear that I got on here. I will have to sand it with some 400 or 600 grit, make it smooth, and then I'll spray a flow coat over it. Once I put the flow coat on there, it'll be flawless and it'll look like a mirror. But right here, you can see my bike hanging on the wall there in the reflection. So yeah, it looks good. I hope you all enjoy this. Thanks for watching. Thanks for sharing. Thanks for subscribing, commenting, everything. And I'll be doing the next one soon. And it's probably going to be, I'll surprise you with the color. So you got something to look forward to. But thanks, everyone. Thanks for watching. Have an awesome day.